Okay, good morning. Okay, what are the objectives of this video lesson? On completion of this period, you would be able to know the electrochemical theory of corrosion, different types of galvanic cells formed during the corrosion, understand the process of rusting of iron. Okay. After completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know the electrochemical theory of corrosion, different types of galvanic cells formed during the corrosion, understand the process of rusting of iron. Main objectives of this video lesson. Okay, in this video lesson, first we discuss about electrochemical theory of corrosion. Okay. This theory was introduced by Whiteney. This theory explains the formation of galvanic cell during the corrosion. Okay, we discuss the salient features of electrochemical theory. Okay, listen. According to this theory, corrosion is an electrochemical process. Okay, a galvanic cell is formed during the corrosion. Why? Because corrosion is an electrochemical process. In the electrochemical process, we take galvanic cell. So, a galvanic cell is formed during the corrosion. It is formed between two different metals or different parts of a metal. Okay, when corrosion takes place, galvanic cell is set up. Galvanic cell is set up means that contain two types of anode. One is anode, another one is cathode. So, listen, corrosion is an electrochemical process or electrochemical corrosion. If corrosion is an electrochemical process, galvanic cell is formed. It is formed between two different metals or different parts of a metal. Two different metal means one metal act as anode, another metal act as cathode. Or you take two parts in the metal, one part act as anode, another part act as cathode. Okay, generally, metals are electropositive in nature. That means they have tendency to lose their electrons. Okay, where the electrons are lost in the metal, that part act as anode. Where the electrons are gained in the metal, that part act as cathode. Okay, listen, generally metals are electropositive in nature. They have tendency to lose their electrons. Okay. Galvanic cell is formed during the corrosion. So in galvanic cell, oxidation occurs at anode. In galvanic cell, already you know that oxidation occurs at anode. So anodic metal is destroyed. Okay, in a galvanic cell, which metal act as a anodic metal? At that oxidation occurs, so anodic metal is destroyed. Hence corrosion occurs at anode. In a galvanic cell, oxidation occurs at anode, so anodic metal is destroyed. Destroyed means corrosion occurs at anode. Similarly, at cathode, reduction takes place. At that metal or at that part, H plus or H2O and oxygen gain electrons and form OH minus or O minus 2 ions. Okay, if we take one metal, this is the metal. This is anode. This part act as cathode. Okay, listen. Okay, if we take one metal, in that metal we take two parts. One part act as anode, another part act as cathode. Means galvanic cell is set up on this metal surface. Okay, oxidation occurs at anode. That means this metal lost its electrons. That means this metal is destroyed. So corrosion occurs at anode. Okay. At cathode, some atmospheric gases present in the atmosphere. Those are H2O, oxygen. This metal gain electrons. That means here, this is the metal surface. One part act as anode, another part act as cathode. Okay, first, which part act as anode? Their oxidation occur. So at that part, metal lost its electrons. Metal lost its electrons means metal will be destroyed. That means corrosion will be occurred at anode. At metal lost its electron, those electrons are transferred to or moved to cathodic area. When electrons are moved to cathodic area, some gases present surround the cathodic area. Those are H2O, H2O2. These gain these electrons and form OH minus and O minus 2. So the cathode metal is protected from corrosion. The cathode metal is protected from corrosion. Here, corrosion takes place. At anodic area, corrosion takes place. At cathodic area, metal is protected from corrosion. Why? Because at anodic area, oxidation takes place. That means metal lost its electrons. That means metal will be, when metal lost its electrons, metal will be destroyed. That means corrosion occurs at anode. If some gases gain electrons at the cathode, those are form OH minus 2 and O minus 2 on the metal surface. That means cathodic metal is protected from the corrosion. Okay. Okay, listen. Already we discuss, take one metal surface. One part act as anode, another part act as cathode. This is A, this is C. Okay, listen. Okay, at anodic area, metal lost its electrons. When metal lost its electron, form Mn plus plus N electrons plus N electrons. Okay, here metal means M lost its electrons, form Mn plus and N electrons. Then N electrons are transferred to cathodic area. When N electrons are reached at the cathodic area, some gases like H2O, O2 present. This gain these electrons and form OH minus. Okay, here Mn plus C is formed. Here OH minus ions are formed. These two are combined through the conducting medium and form MOH of N. This is about the electrochemical theory of corrosion. Electrochemical theory of corrosion. Okay, in this theory, if we take two different metals or take two different parts on the same metal, one part act as anode, another part act as cathode. When galvanic cell is set up on the metal, which part act as anode? Their oxidation takes place. That means metal lost its electrons. That means metal will be destroyed. That means corrosion occurs at anodic area. When metal lost its electrons, those electrons are transferred to the cathodic area. When electrons are reached at the cathodic area, some gases present H2O, O2. Those gain electrons and form OH- on the metal surface. So this is the OH-. This OH minus and Mn plus combine and form MOH of N. So finally, in the electrochemical theory, which top of product is formed? MOH of N. Okay, now we discuss about galvanic cells, different types of galvanic cells. Okay, some galvanic cells are formed during the corrosion of a metal. Okay, some galvanic cells are formed during the corrosion of a metal. According to that, these cells are divided into three types. One is composition cell, another one is stress cell, another one is concentration cell. Okay, composition cell formed between two different metals. Stress cell formed due to difference in energy. Next, concentration cell formed due to the difference in concentration of electrolyte or differential aeration. Okay, we discuss one by one. Okay, listen, first we discuss about composition cell. How the composition cell is formed means when two different metals are in contact with each other surrounded by an electrolyte. Okay, a composition cell is formed when two different metals are in contact with each other surrounded by an electrolyte. Okay, generally galvanic cell is formed. This galvanic cell contains two metals. One metal act as anode, another metal act as cathode. Okay, which metal act as anode that undergoes corrosion, already we have discussed. Which metal act as cathode that is prevented from undergoing corrosion, already we have discussed in the electrochemical theory. Okay, listen, a composition cell is formed when two different metals are in contact with each other surrounded by an electrolyte. That means this is the galvanic cell setup. Okay, in this galvanic cell setup, two different metals are there. One metal act as anode that undergoes corrosion. Which metal act as anode that undergoes corrosion? Next, which metal act as cathode that is prevented from undergoing corrosion? Already we have discussed in the electrochemical theory. Okay, listen, the metal acting as anode, already we have taken galvanic cell setup. In that galvanic setup, cell setup, two different metals are there. One metal act as anode, another metal act as cathode. How the metals act as anode and cathode means, the metal undergoing corrosion, that means that metal act as anode, is determined by its position in the electrochemical series. How the metal act as anode is determined by its position in the electrochemical series. Now, what is the electrochemical series means? The electrochemical series is the series in which metals are arranged in a increasing order of standard reduction potential values. That means a decreasing order of electropositive character. Okay, listen, the electrochemical series, what is the electrochemical series means? In which metals are arranged in increasing order of standard reduction potential values. Okay, metals arranged in a increasing order of standard reduction potential values are called electrochemical series. How the metal act as an anode is determined by its position in the electrochemical series. Listen, this is the electrochemical series. This is the electrochemical series. In this series, these metals are arranged in the increasing order of their standard reduction potential values. Okay, in this electrochemical series, reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom. In this electrochemical series, reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom. Reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom means electropositive character also decreases. Generally, metals lose their electrons. Generally, metals have a tendency to lose their electrons. Which metal lost its electrons easily? That metal reactivity is high or electropositive nature is also high. That means in this series, Reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom, means electropositive character also decreases. That means tendency to undergo oxidation also decreases. That means tendency to lose electrons also decreases. Tendency to undergo oxidation also decreases. Tendency to act as anode decreases. Next show, tendency to lose electrons decreases means tendency to undergo corrosion also decreases. Okay, listen, remember. This is the electrochemical series. In this series, metals are arranged in the increasing order of their standard reduction potential values. In this series, reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom. Okay, so tendency to lose its electrons also decreases. So tendency to undergo corrosion also decreases. According to this electrochemical theories, which metal is more reactive that act as anode? Which metal is less reactive? That metal act as cathode. Okay, if we take zinc and chromium, zinc is the high reactive metal compared to chromium. That means chromium is less reactive metal. If we set up the galvanic cell by these two metals, this zinc act as anode. Why? Because this is the high reactive metal. Next, chromium act as cathode. Why? Because chromium reactivity is less. That means in this electrochemical theory, in this electrochemical series, which metal is placed upper that act as anode, which metal is placed lower that act as cathode. Remember this thing, which metal is placed upper that act as anode, which metal is placed lower that metal act as cathode. Okay, listen, when two metals are connected and exposed to an electrolyte, that means galvanic cell is set up by two metals. At that time, a composition cell is formed. Okay, when two metals are connected and exposed to an electrolyte, a composition cell is formed, or galvanic cell is formed. This type of galvanic cell is called composition cell. Okay, in these two metal, which metal present in upper part of electrochemical series act as anode, that metal undergoes corrosion. Okay, this composition cell or galvanic cell is formed by two metals. These are connected and exposed to an electrolyte. In these two metals, which metal present in upper part of electrochemical series, that metal act as an anode, means that metal lost its electrons. That means that will be destroyed, that will undergo corrosion. Okay, we take, for example, when zinc and copper are present in an electrolyte, in these two metal, zinc metal present in upper part of electrochemical series, copper metal present in lower part of electrochemical series. So zinc act as anode, copper act as cathode. So zinc undergoes corrosion. Okay, when composition cell is formed by zinc and copper metals, zinc present in upper part of electrochemical series, that means it act as anode, that means it lost its electrons, it will be destroyed and also undergo corrosion. Next, copper is placed lower part of electrochemical series, this act as cathode, it is prevented from corrosion. Okay, next, another example, when iron and tin are present in electrolyte, iron metal is placed upper part in electrochemical series, that means it act as anode, that means it lost its electrons, that means it will be destroyed and it undergoes corrosion. Tin is placed lower part in the electrochemical series, so it act as cathode, that means it is prevented from corrosion. This is the explanation of composition cell. So how the composition cell is formed, when two metals are connected and exposed to an electrolyte. Okay, listen, next second type of galvanic cell, that is stress cell. It is formed due to difference in energy or stress. Okay, if we take one metal, in that metal some parts being stress, some parts are not being stress. Okay, which part being stress that act as anode, which part is not being stress that part act as cathode. So galvanic cell is set up by difference in stress. So stress cell means it is formed due to difference in energy or stress. Listen, when a metal is subjected to severe stress, the part of the metal experiencing high stress. Okay, when a metal is subjected to severe stress, that part of the metal experiencing high stress can have higher energy and act as anode. That means if we take one metal, in that metal which part have severe stress or high stress, that part act as anode. Okay, some other parts have less stress, that parts act as cathode. Okay, listen, hence the part of metal with more stress, that part act as anode. Which part act as anode? That undergoes corrosion. Okay, next, the part of metal with less stress, that part act as cathode, that undergoes corrosion not easily. Okay, this is about the stress cells. Listen, it is formed due to difference in energy or stress. When a metal is subjected to severe stress, the part of the metal experiencing high stress can have higher energy. That means where the severe stress or high stress present, that part can have high energy, that part act as anode. Okay, similarly, some other parts have low stress, that part have less energy, that part act as cathode. Okay, hence the part of metal with more stress, that part act as anode, that part undergoes corrosion easily. Next, similarly, the part of metal with less stress, that part act as cathode, that undergoes corrosion not easily. Okay, we discuss some examples for stress cell. We take nail. This is the nail. This is the head part. This is the tail part. This is the head. This is the tail part. Generally, if we apply the force on the nail, generally force mainly present on head and nail. Okay, if we apply the force on the nail, generally force present head and nail. So in the nail, head and tail parts are being stressed. Okay, these head and tail parts act as anode. So these parts undergo corrosion. Next, remaining part, this is the remaining part. This part act as, that means unstressed part in the nail. So it act as cathode, it is prevented from corrosion. Collision, generally we observe the nail where the rust will be appeared, means head and tail parts are rusted. Why? Because when force apply on nail, force mainly present on head and tail. So these two parts are stressed parts. So these two parts act as anode. So these two parts undergo corrosion in a nail. Next, remaining part, this is the remaining part. This is the unstressed part in a nail. So it act as cathode. So it does not undergo corrosion easily. Okay, this is one type of stress cell. Nail is the one type of stress cell. Okay, next we take another example of stress cell. That is bent pipes. These are the bent pipe. This is also another type of U-tube, U-type of pipe. Okay. In bent pipes, the curved parts are stressed and act as anode, and uncurved parts act as cathode. The anode parts undergoes corrosion. Okay, listen, this is the bent pipe. This is the U-type of pipe. Here, this is the curved part. This curved part is being stressed in a bent pipe. This curved part is being a stressed part in a bent pipe. This curved part act as anode, so this part undergo corrosion easily. Next, this remaining part or this remaining part is unstressed part in a bent pipe. So this remaining part act as cathode and it does not undergo corrosion easily. Okay, in a bent pipe where the curved part is there, that curved part act as anode that undergo corrosion easily. Next, remaining part, this is the remaining part, this is the unstressed part, it act as cathode, it does not undergo corrosion easily. Undergo corrosion easily. Next, this is the U type of pipe. Here this is curved is there, here also curved is there. This curved part is being stressed part, so it act as anode, it undergo corrosion easily. Next, this remaining part, this is the remaining part, unstressed part, it act as cathode, it does not undergo corrosion easily. Okay, in a bent pipe where the curved parts are present, those act as anode, undergo corrosion easily. Next, remaining parts are unstressed parts, those act as cathode, those does not undergo corrosion easily. This is about the stress cells. Okay, next we discuss about concentration cell. This is third type of galvanic cell. Okay, how the concentration cell is formed means, this cell is formed due to difference in the concentration of electrolyte or atmospheric oxygen. Okay, concentration cell is formed due to difference in the concentration of electrolyte or atmospheric oxygen. Okay, the part of a metal which is present in the area of less oxygen, that part will act as anode and that part undergo corrosion easily. Okay, if we take one metal, in that metal which part is present in the area of less oxygen, that part act as anode that undergo corrosion easily. Next, remaining part, that part exposed to more oxygen, that will act as cathode, that does not undergo corrosion easily. Okay, listen, what is the concentration cell? The concentration cell is formed due to the difference in the concentration of electrolyte or atmospheric oxygen. Okay, the part of metal which is present in the area of less oxygen, that part will act as anode that undergoes corrosion easily. Next, the part of metal exposed to more oxygen, that part act as cathode that does not undergo corrosion easily. This is about the concentration cell. Okay, next we discuss example of concentration cell. A concentration cell is formed when zinc plate is kept in NaCl solution. Okay, you observe this diagram. In this diagram, we take one beaker and take some water in the beaker, and one zinc rod is placed in the water. Okay, you observe in the zinc rod, which part kept in the water, that is less oxygenated part. Which part not kept in the water, that is more oxygenated part. Okay, generally, you take water in the bucket, you put the one iron rod, you observe after some days, which part kept in the water, that part will get rusted. Remaining part will not get rusted. Similarly, here also, zinc rod is placed in the water or NaCl solution. Zinc rod is placed in the NaCl solution. Which part kept in the NaCl solution? That is less oxygenated part. That part act as anode. That part undergo corrosion. This is the corroding anode. This zinc lost its electrons, form zinc plus 2 ion. Next, which part is not kept in the NaCl solution? That is more oxygenated part. So this part act as cathode. This will not undergo corrosion easily. Okay. Next, we discuss another example. A concentration cell is formed during the rusting of iron. Okay, this is the iron metal. This is the surface of iron metal. One water drop present on the iron surface. Dirt present on the iron surface. That part is less oxygenated part. Remaining part is more oxygenated part. Means where the water drop or dirt present on the iron surface, that part is less oxygenated part. So that act as anode and undergo corrosion easily. Remaining part is more oxygenated part that act as cathode. These parts do not undergo corrosion easily. This is about the another example. Okay, a concentration cell is formed during the rusting of iron. Collision. Iron corrodes under drop of water or dirt. The area which have free access to air containing more oxygenated act as anode. These parts do not undergo corrosion easily. Next, the area under the droplet or dirt have less access to air becomes anode due to low oxygen and undergo corrosion easily. Next, we discuss another topic, that is rusting of iron. Generally, we are using different metals like copper, silver, gold, tin, zinc in our daily life. Okay, these metals, these metals are used in our daily life. Mainly, iron is a hard metal. Fe is a hard metal, widely used and more abundant in nature. Okay, generally iron is used in the construction of buildings or construction of machineries or construction of industries. So iron is a hard metal, widely used and more abundant in nature. Okay, iron can be molded into sheets, rods, wires, etc. Already we know that iron can be molded into sheets, rods, wires, etc. Because of its strength, Iron widely used in bridges, rails, machinery, factories, etc. Because of iron strength, widely used in bridges, rails, machineries, factories, etc. Okay. All metals undergo corrosion when they are exposed to oxygen in air. Okay, generally, all type of metals undergo corrosion when they are exposed to oxygen in air. Iron is severely affected by atmospheric oxygen. Iron is severely affected by atmospheric oxygen. The heaviest corrosion of iron is called rusting of iron. Generally, we observe in our surroundings, iron material is rusted. Why? Because iron is severely affected by atmospheric oxygen. When exposed to air, reddish layer is formed on iron surface. When iron metal is exposed to air, a reddish layer is formed on surface. Okay. Nearly 20% of produced iron in the nation is wasted by corrosion. Nearly 20% of produced iron in the nation is wasted by corrosion. Okay. Next, corrosion is a slow process. Generally, corrosion is a slow process, but rusting of iron takes place quickly. Rusting of iron takes place quickly. That means corrosion of iron takes place quickly. The rust, iron oxide develops cracks in the metal. The rust, that means iron oxide develops cracks in the iron metal. Iron loses its strength. The oxide layer bulks. Okay, next lesson. Some necessary conditions for the rusting of iron. How the iron will be rusted. Some conditions will be there, then iron will be rusted. Those are necessary conditions for the rusting of iron. First one is impure state of metal. That means iron metal contain impurities that will undergo corrosion easily or that will be rusted easily. Or moisture present surround the iron metal that will undergo corrosion easily or that will be rusted easily. Or O2 and CO2 present in the atmosphere, iron will get rusted easily. Next, electrolytes present in the atmosphere. Electrolytes, that means some solutions present in the atmosphere, then iron will get rusted easily. Next, pH of electrolyte. Generally, metals undergo corrosion easily in acidic media. That means acidic nature present around the iron metal, iron will get rusted easily. Next, temperature. If temperature increases, corrosion also increases. Why? Because corrosion is a chemical process. When temperature increases, rate of reaction increases. That means rate of undergoing corrosion also increases. These are the necessary conditions for the rusting of iron. So what are the impure state of the metal? Moisture, O2 and CO2 present in the atmosphere, electrolytes present in the atmosphere, pH of electrolytes, temperature. These are the necessary conditions for the rusting of iron. Now we summarize this video lesson. What we have discussed in the video lesson is, first one, we discussed electrochemical theory. Okay, this theory explains the corrosion. Okay, corrosion can be explained by electrochemical theory. This theory states that corrosion takes place due to formation of galvanic cell. According to this theory, corrosion takes place due to formation of galvanic cell. Okay, three types of galvanic cells are formed during the corrosion. Those are composition cell, stress cell, and concentration cell. Okay, three types of galvanic cells are formed during the corrosion. Those are composition cell, stress cell, and concentration cell. Okay. First, composition cells are formed due to difference in composition of metals. Okay. composition cells are formed due to difference in composition of metals. Next, stress cells are formed due to difference in stress on various parts of metal. Next, concentration cells are formed due to difference in concentration of oxygen. All these cells we have discussed. Composition cells are formed due to difference in composition of metals. Stress cells are formed due to difference in stress on various parts of metals. Concentration cells are formed due to difference in concentration of oxygen. Okay, next we have also discussed corrosion of metals, that means rusting of iron. Conditions for the rusting of iron: oxygen layer as protection, non-protection layer, effects of corrosion. All these topics we have covered in this video lesson. Okay, next we discuss some multiple choice questions on this video lesson. Corrosion can be explained by A. Arrhenius theory, B. ionization theory, C. electrochemical theory, D. Lewis theory. Already we have discussed that is electrochemical theory. So C is the correct answer. Corrosion can be explained by electrochemical theory. Okay, next question. A concentration cell is formed due to difference in composition of metals, energy of metals, aeration of metals, all the above. Already we know that aeration of metals. C is the correct answer. A concentration cell is formed due to difference in aeration of metals. C is the correct answer. Okay, next question. Which of the following cell is formed when copper and zinc metals are in contact in the presence of electrolyte? Listen. Which of the following cell is formed when copper and zinc, two different metals, are in contact in the presence of electrolyte? A. Stress cell, B. Concentration cell, C. Composition cell, D. All of the above. Already know that that is the composition cell. Two different metals means composition cell is formed by two different metals or contact in the presence of electrolyte. C is the correct answer. Okay, next we discuss another question. In galvanic cell, corrosion takes place at anode only, cathode only, both anode and cathode, none of the above. Already we have discussed. Generally, corrosion takes place at anodic area in a galvanic cell. A is the correct answer. A galvanic cell, corrosion takes place at anode only. Next, we discuss another question. In corrosion process, metals are reduced, oxidized, neutralized, unchanged. Where the oxidation takes place, at that place undergo corrosion. So corrosion, in corrosion process, metals are oxidized. Metals are oxidized. B is the correct answer. In corrosion process, metals are oxidized. B is the correct answer. Okay, next, another question. In corrosion process, oxygen is oxidized, reduced, neutralized, none. Okay, in the corrosion process, we take metal. On the metal surface, one part act as anode, another part act as cathode. Which part act as anode? At that part, metal lost its electron. That means in that part, metal undergo oxidation. Next, another part act as cathode. At that part, oxygen surround on the metal surface, oxygen gain electrons. That means oxygen is reduced. So in corrosion process, oxygen is reduced. B is the correct answer. In the corrosion process, oxygen is reduced. Next, we discuss another question. In oxidation process, electrons are lost, gained, no change, both A and B. So A is the correct. Oxidation process, electrons lost. Next, we discuss another question. Corrosion is a chemical change, physical change, both A and B, none of the above. Already we discussed corrosion is a electrochemical process or chemical change. So corrosion is a chemical change. A is the correct answer. A is the correct answer. Okay, in this video lessons, which topics have been covered? On that topics, some questions are asked frequently in the examination. What those are questions means? First one is, write about electrochemical theory of corrosion. Next, second question, explain the formation of different types of galvanic cell formed during the corrosion with the examples. And also asked to explain the composition cell, or explain the stress cell, or explain the concentration cell. Next one, what is rusting of iron? State the conditions necessary for the rusting of iron. Okay, these questions are asked frequently. Listen, write about electrochemical theory of corrosion. Explain the formation of different types of galvanic cells formed during the corrosion with an example. What is rusting of iron? State the conditions necessary for the rusting of iron. Okay, thank you, all of you. Okay, mainly in this video lesson, we discussed about electrochemical theory. Next, types of different galvanic cells. Next one, rusting of iron. Okay, thank you.